Hello, Kingdom Fun, third and fourth grade ministry lesson for Sunday, July 12th, 2020. I am Miss Allison, and Miss CJ will be joining us as well. Our topic today is Peter and Tabitha. Our scripture reading is in Acts chapter 9, verses 36 to 43. Our Bible memory verse is Acts chapter 2. 36 to 38, and our focus is God works through our faith. So then, what is faith? Something to believe in, a conviction, a belief, optimism, someone you trust, being hopeful, having confidence. In what do you have faith? You can have faith in money, that money can help you get something, can help you do something. You have faith in your own strength, that in your own ability to be able to do something. In your friends, that they'll be there for you, your mom, your dad. In your own knowledge, that you're smart. You can figure this out, but you should have faith in God. That is what we are called as Christians, to have faith in God in all areas. And so I put that one on knowledge, because a lot of times as you get more and more education, you begin to rely on yourself and not on God. And so knowledge becomes your faith instead of where that God is your faith. Acts chapter 9, verses 36 to 39. In Joppa, there was a disciple named Tabitha. She was always doing good and helping the poor. About that time, she became sick and died, and her body was washed and placed in an upstairs room. Lydda was near Joppa, so when the disciples heard that Peter was in Lydda, they sent two men to him and urged him, "Please come at once." Acts chapter 9, verses 40 through 43.
Peter sent them out of the room. Then he got down on his knees and prayed. Turning toward the dead woman, he said, "Tabitha, get up." She opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He took her by the hand and helped her to her feet. Then he called for the believers, especially the widows, and presented her to them alive. This became known all over Joppa, and many people believed in the Lord. Peter stayed in Joppa for some time with a tanner named Simon.
Peter went with them, and when he arrived, he was... Peter went with them, and when he arrived, he was taken upstairs to the room. All the widows stood around him, crying and showing him the robes and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was still with them. Peter went with them. Chapter 9, verses 36 through 39. Who had faith? Well, the two men that went to go get Peter had faith that Peter was able to do something. They have heard things about what Peter had been doing around town, so they had faith that he could help. Peter believed that God would heal Tabitha. And how do I know that? Let's continue reading. Acts chapter 9, verses 40 through 43.
Peter sent them out of the room. Then he got down on his knees and prayed. Turning toward the dead woman, he said, "Tabitha, get up." She opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He took her by the hand and helped her to her feet. Then he called for the believers, especially the widows, and presented her to them alive. This became known all over Joppa, and many people believed in the Lord. Peter stayed in Joppa for some time with a tanner named Simon.
Peter cleared out the room, and he got on his knees and he prayed. Peter had faith that God was going to heal Tabitha. So then what happened Many people believe in the Lord after seeing Tabitha alive again. So the power of Peter's faith in God helped all the people that saw it believe in God too. Wow, that's powerful. Short lesson today. We have a couple review questions. And the first one is a challenge, a math challenge for you. And it says, Peter and the two men had to walk from Lydda to Joppa. The cities were about 10 miles apart. If the three of them walked 3 miles per hour, then how long would it take them to walk? You can pause the video and figure out that problem, and we'll come back to it later. Question number one, why did the two men go find Peter? Pause the video and answer that question. They heard the miracles that Peter had done. They had faith that Peter could help. Number two, what did Peter have to restore Tabitha to life? Pause the video and answer that question. Peter had faith in God to raise Tabitha from the dead. So Peter's faith helped so many other people believe in God. And so I tell you that because that's your power, is that you have faith in God, and your experiences that you go through will lead other people to know God. So my prayer over you is that you have a personal relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That is a prayer that I've always prayed over my own children, is that I can show them who I believe in, but God and their relationship with God is what ultimately what I want. I don't want them to be looking at me for God, access to God. I want each one of you and my children to be able to go directly to our Lord and Savior. And so build that relationship with Him. Spend time with God so that you know when He's talking to you. And so it reminds me of a news show, ABC News, a couple of days ago, of a lady in D.C., and she's 107 years old, and she survived the flu of 1912 and COVID-19. She survived COVID-19 at 107. And the reporter asked her, what accounts for your longevity, your long life? And she said a couple things like exercise and those kind of things. But what I really love, she said to be curious. She had a love of curiosity. And so she loved to paint and have sculptures and curious about the world around her. And so I implore you, I ask you to be curious about God. Ask Him questions. He will come you with the answer. He will direct you to a scripture. Someone will say something to answer that question that you had asked God in your private time. And so build that relationship with Him. Be curious about Him. Let Him reveal Himself to you. And that's my prayer for each and every one of you. Back to our math challenge. So, hopefully you got about 3 hours, probably like 3 1/3, a little over 3 hours it took Peter to walk from Lydda to Joppa. So what about the other two men? Because they went from Lydda to Joppa, back to Joppa. They had to walk about 6 hours, a little bit more than 6 hours, maybe 6.5 hours, so close, to get Peter. Wow. They had faith in Peter. So Peter walked And then he prayed. And then the people believed. They believed when they saw Tabitha restored to life. And so it's power in our prayers. It's power in our words. In the comments, there is a small activity for you. And it is a matching. On here, it says that you can cut out column B and then match it with column A. But I also updated it. So the one that you'll see will say, just draw lines. You can just match it. That's easy enough. Just draw lines from column A to column B, the matching statement. Okay? And then once you do that, there are two questions. What if a hard time happens to you? What is your plan? I have a plan when I go through hard times, I spend more time with God. And when I'm going through happy times, I know I reduce the time I spend with God, so I make sure I try to I spend time reading my Bible, being by myself, thinking, having that time to be with God. And so when I'm feeling low, so it may not be a difficult situation that you're going through, but sometimes even if you're feeling down, is what do you do when you're going through that? And so you have to have a plan. You can't wait till it happens. What are you going to do? If you're feeling down, I will talk to someone. Share it. It always makes you feel better to know that you're going through something and you're not going through it alone. Somebody is there with you. Okay? And so that's important. And so have time, your favorite scripture verse. You can write it on a postcard. Have it someplace where you can read it easily. And then the last question is, how might God work through your faith? So some of the things that we go through, just like Jesus went through life so that we could learn through his life, we go through things that bring other people to the knowledge of God. And so there are many things where you have faith that God is going to help you, that you can't see it, but it's going to happen. And when it does, that's a powerful testimony to share with someone else, to let them know what God has done for you. Our memory verse, Acts chapter 2, verses 36 through 38. All the people of Israel then are to know for sure that this Jesus whom you crucified is the one that God has made Lord and Messiah. When the people heard this, they were deeply troubled and said to Peter and the other apostles, "What shall we do, brothers?" Peter said to them, "Each one of you must turn away from your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins will be forgiven and you will receive God's gift, the Holy Spirit." Is there anything in these verses that requires you to have faith? Pause the video and think about it. Absolutely, there is. To believe that when you're baptized, our sins are forgiven and we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit is faith. It requires faith. So I want you to look up Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. And it says, "Faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see." And so you can't see that your sins are forgiven, but you have assurance that they are. That is faith. That is faith. So, I pray that each one of you increases your level of faith in our Lord, that He gives you understanding and wisdom and knowledge that you did not know before. Be curious about Him. Spend time with Him. Develop that relationship with Him. And so I pray health over all of you, that you will be well this week and in the future. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Remember, we love you at Kingdom Fun, and we can't wait for us to be together soon. Have a wonderful rest of your summer. Bye.